Good morning, my darlings.
Good morning.
Thanks for tuning in to the Kelissa in the Morning show. We have an awesome show lined up for you today, so stay tuned. And don't forget, we are the hottest show on the network, and this is how we do it. Don't touch that dial.
This is how we do it.
Welcome to the Kelissa in the Morning show. I'm Jay Parker, sitting in with Kelissa.
Yes.
Hey, Kelissa, how you doing?
Hey, good morning, my darlings.
Wow, we are so honored that you decided to make us a part of your morning. So on behalf of the WAEC Love 860 family, we say welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome. Yeah. And
thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, I got a lot of awesome information lined up in this show for you today. So make sure that you stay tuned.
That's right.
Traffic is horrible,
horrible
in Atlanta this morning. And it's hot, too.
Yes, it's hot.
Lord
yes.
have mercy.
Oh, my goodness. Be careful out there.
So how did you fare in the traffic this morning, Ms. Kelissa?
I didn't. I did not.
You didn't?
No. I can't believe it. And then I was just talking to Larry, and I was telling him, these old people, they're still driving.
Larry, why would old people still be driving? He just shakes his head. He's like, I don't even know. But you know what? Now, we can't take it away from our old people. They get down.
But they're driving like 2 to 5 miles an hour. Yeah. And I'm like, where are their children? Like, I would not let my mom be driving or my dad like that. Like, oh.
Not at 98, but maybe in the 70s
and
80s. Oh, God.
It takes like 5 minutes to turn. Can't see over the dashboard.
Just can't see. Just short.
Oh God.
But well spent in years. That's good though.
Yeah.
It's a blessing to get old. So we applaud our old people.
Right.
Older people.
And I tell my let me drive when I get that old.
Oh, well, I still might try. Look, I want all 120 years. I'm gonna be driving my car until I'm about 110, and nobody's gonna be changing my Huggies every day either.
Oh!
I'm gonna be still doing my thing. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, I am. So we want to give an honorable mention to I Am Life t-shirts by TNT Creations,
mm-hmm.
where the feeling of life begins.
Yeah,
that's our lady Miss Foy there in Texas.
Yes, it is.
All right.
And then we have another one.
And Greater Works Mission,
mm-hmm.
headed by Candace Ruffin.
Exactly.
Hey, Miss Candace, we love you. We hope you're listening.
Right.
Now let's get into the topic of the show.
Let's get into the topic of the show. So
let's do that.
Thank you so much. This morning, we have a wonderful, awesome young man who's going to be in the studio with us talking, and he's going to be talking about mindset management. He works with the youth. He's a youth motivator as well as a speaker, and I'm so excited to have him on our show. And at this time, we're going to talk to Isaac.
Isaac Moore, are you on the line?
I'm on the line. Can you guys hear me?
Yes, we can. How are you this morning?
I'm doing good. How are you guys this morning?
Oh, we're doing great. How's the weather?
You know, we had some storms last night, but it's clearing up.
Okay, it's clearing up. Well, that's good. That's good. You had any plans for this weekend?
No, I really don't have anything. Probably read a couple books or something.
Okay, that's awesome.
So, again, that's Isaac Moore Jr.
Mm-hmm.
He's joining us live via telephone.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be asking questions relevant to what he knows about challenges he has been faced with in working with the youth.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, the youth. What a challenge. What a challenge working with the youth.
What age group do you work with?
So I work with any age group from the ages of like 6 to 17.
Oh, wow. Okay. 6 to 17. Is that all at the same time or just different age groups at a different at certain times? How do you do that?
No, we usually have to like break it up in like certain age groups. So we'll do like, you know, 6 to maybe 10 and then 10 to 14, then 15 to 17, something like that.
Okay.
And, we tried to do, you know, work with all in one group, but it didn't work out too well. So.
Right, right. So then you have to go back and revamp, right? Go back to the drawing board.
Right, right.
Okay, so to my listening audience, again, this is Isaac Moore Jr. He is a speaker as well as a youth motivator, and we're going to delve into some awesome information he has, how you can get in contact with him. Again, if you haven't already, head over to my website, which is at www.kelissabass.com. And, you know, I want to let people know that the autobiography that I have on my website is a really awesome book that really gets into a lot of detail about child abuse and domestic violence. And so I want you to go over and get a copy of that book, because the book is really good and I think it'll help a lot of people. So make sure you go to the website. Again, it's www.kelissabass.com.
Right. Again, live via telephone in the studio, we have our special guest, Isaac Moore Jr. Mm-hmm. Mindset management is what we're going to be talking about today. Mm-hmm. But before we hear from our special guest, we want to welcome the listening audience again and ask you to call in and engage the guests with your questions. Again, we'll be discussing mindset management with Isaac Moore Jr., who, by the way, is a speaker and youth motivator. If you're living in the Atlanta metropolitan area, you can give us a shout at 404-355-8699. Around the country, 866-923-2860. Mm-hmm. And so, Isaac Moore Jr., I'm going to tell the listening audience a little bit about Isaac Moore, if that's okay.
Yeah, let's do that.
Isaac Moore Jr. was born in Michigan City, Indiana. Upon graduating high school in 2013, he went to attend Indiana University Northwest, where he is expected to graduate in 2017 as an inspiring motivational speaker and life coach for youth. He has set out to change the mindset in which we view today's generation. He has authored and self-published his own book entitled 9 to 5, where he gives job advice for first-time job seekers through his personal experience. Isaac goes by a simple mantra of impact, improve, inspire, and hopes.
His voice
and his message is able to inspire youth to stand up, mm-hmm. chase their dreams, and become the best version of themselves they can be. Isaac serves as a community volunteer for various programs and a mentor for today's youth, even being nationally recognized as an outstanding mentor. Isaac believes that there's more to be done, and we must all accept the challenge. He believes that's the true definition of leadership.
Wow.
I agree with you.
Yes, I do as well.
Wow. You know, it's funny because my son, when he went to get a job, he was like, "Dad, I don't know why they won't hire me." I said, "Well, send me a picture of yourself." Man, mm-hmm. he was a hot mess. Gold teeth all over the place.
Oh, God.
He had dreads down to his elbows. I said, "Lord, man, I wouldn't hire you either." Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm. So he got it together quick, and he got a job.
Right. Oh, see? And so, Isaac, when you go into your book, again, his book is called 9 to 5. What are you doing? Preparing them for the job, or do resume building? What are you doing with the youth to prepare them for?
Yeah, so it's kind of like a preparation.
Mm-hmm. So you prepare them for a job.
Yeah, it's kind of like a preparation guide.
In which way?
I guess you can say. So it answers some of the questions that they may have about, you know, what do I put on the job application? I never had a job before. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, how to answer some of those tough questions that I've came to realize, you know, people struggle with. So.
Okay. And do you find that prevalent among the young women or the men?
It could be both. Like, I think it's a struggle.
Really?
Both. Yeah. You know, I think, you know, when I was doing the research about it, mm-hmm. one of the bigger questions was, in an interview, they always ask you, tell me about yourself.
Correct.
And a lot of people struggle with answering that question. So what I did, in a spot in my book, I asked the question and I put some lines in the book so you can practice answering that question.
Okay.
So I think it's a pretty interactive way, and, you know, and there's no right or wrong answer. It's just I call it a get better answer. Like, over time, you can get better at it. So.
Okay. Well, you know, in preparation of having you as a guest on the Kelissa in the Morning Show, I've researched and learned a lot about you, and I think that you're an awesome individual. I really love what you're doing. I went to some of your pages, saw some of your videos, and all the kids you took pictures with. So you're really out there doing a lot. But tell my listening audience here, who is Isaac Moore?
Oh, man. So Isaac Moore is that person that, you know, had a really, really big dream and didn't know where to start.
Mm-hmm.
And so he just got started.
Okay.
And, like, it just took off from there. You know, I grew up. I grew up in a, you know, single family household. My mom left me when I was about 2 months old. And so, like, as I got older and I started to, you know, hear the stories about, like, single family homes, like, I realized that it could be a turning point or a making point.
Okay.
And, you know, I just kind of took in stride everything that my dad taught me, some of the values that he taught me, and watching him be a single father and doing the best job possible, like, it motivated me to do the best job possible in any way I could.
So. Okay. And do you find that challenging when you are talking to the youth that come that are raised in single-parent households?
Sometimes I do. But, you know, it's one of those things, like, you never really know the situation.
Right.
You know, there's kids who could be going through something but still smile because maybe going to school is escaping from, you know,
what they're going
whatever
through
they're
home.
Going. Mm-hmm. Right. Or if I'm at a summer camp and I'm speaking, you know, that could just be their personal getaway. And, like, you don't ever want to, like, go in and, like, break that getaway. You kind of want to let them live in that.
Okay.
And so, but what I always do, I always try to reach out at the end of any event. You know, I give people, like, my email address and, you know, a phone number where they can reach me just in case they have any questions or if anything I can help them with personally.
Okay. Well, at what point in your life did you decide you wanted to be a leader, and more specifically for the youth?
I think when I was young, you know, it was more about, like, everyone else pitted me as a leader. And, you know, and it was just more so when I was going to step up and embrace, you know, that challenge.
Okay.
Like I said, when I was a little bit younger, everyone was like, were telling me that, oh, man, you'll be a great leader. And I didn't really embrace it. So finally I had to, like, step up to the plate and embrace that role.
Okay. Wow. Okay. And so what age were you about?
I'd say it was right after high school. So I was like 17 or 18.
Right after high school. Oh, okay. Okay. That sounds great. So what other things did you do in high school that kind of led you? Did you take any programs, any clubs you belonged to? What were you doing?
Wow. Like, I played some sports in, like, my freshman year of high school.
Okay.
And, like, after that, like, I was just real, real serene, didn't say too much. You know, I mean, I was cool with everyone, and I knew everyone in the school, pretty popular guy, but, like, I was always second fiddle. Like, I never really stepped up to the plate and embraced, you know, myself.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, my senior year of high school, I think that's when it was. My senior year of high school, it was just, like, it just took off. Like, everyone was like, oh, man, you should, you know, run for class president. You should do this. You should do that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like, finally, I just started, you know, taking up on some of those offers, and it was just, like, just going from there.
Oh, right. You're like, oh, okay. I found my place.
Yeah.
Okay, now tell me something. Answer me a question. I have a 12-year-old, right?
Okay.
Tell me what's going on in the mind of a 12-year-old.
Lord have mercy.
I know.
A lot of cartoons. Maybe.
Okay.
On social media. No, I think in the mind of a 12-year-old in this day, it's really just about fitting in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think that's like an age. It's more like a curious, you have a curious mind. You want to try certain things, or you see your friends doing something. And,
right.
You may not understand why your parents tell you not to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very like, it's like a curiosity state, I like to say.
Okay. And so what would be your advice for the youth that you work with to get them to kind of take their place?
Right. You know, my advice would just be always listen to the people, to your elders. I know it's like a cliche. And
oh, right.
You say it a lot. You know, but you always have to listen. You may not find that information valuable at the time, but, you know, along the line, down the line, that information will come to you, and then it'll be up to you on how you know, take it and perceive it and utilize it. You know, there's things that my dad would tell me, you know, when I was a little bit younger that I didn't quite agree on.
Mm-hmm.
Until this day, I don't agree on, but I can understand why he told me certain things, you know.
Right.
Okay. Well, wow, you know, that's some great information, and we hope that there are some young folks listening since this is the summertime, you know?
Yeah.
And so, but great, great information, Mr. Moore. It's time for us to take a break. So we're going to come back from the break to our 9:30 giveaway.
Yes, we are.
Our 9:30 giveaway is sponsored by Greater Works Mission, headed by Candace Ruffin.
Yes, and she's in Texas, and we're going to make sure that you have all that information. I'm really honored that she has decided to come aboard and be one of the sponsors for the show.
Absolutely. And so if you're in the Atlanta metropolitan area, excuse me, and you want to give us a call and put your hand in for that 9:30 giveaway, give us a call. 404-355-8699 around the country. We can send whatever it is to you that we're going to be giving away, which is?
Which is 4 tickets to Lake Winnie.
Wow, let's go to Lake Winnie,
866-923-2860.
In case you're just tuning in, you're listening to the Kelissa in the Morning Show. We're going to take a break, so we'll be right back. Don't you touch that dial.
Your children, and don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place.
All right, welcome back. In case you're just tuning in, you're listening to Kelissa in the Morning with Kelissa Bass. It's time for our 9:30 giveaway.
Yes, yes.
Woo! It's 9:30.
It's 9:30, so start calling. Again, if you want to take a shot at winning those tickets, you have to be the 8th caller to call in, and the number to call is 404-355-8699. If you're around the country and you want to call, it's 1-866-923-2860.
Absolutely. Mr. Moore, are you still on the line?
Oh, I'm still here, guys. I'm having fun this morning.
All right.
Oh, great.
Well, you know, it's definitely needed. You know, what I realize as a parent is that common sense among our youth is not all that common.
And so yeah, that's true.
You know, it's like you look at him and go, boy, you know you should be. He's like, I didn't know I wasn't supposed to do that. So in regards to getting a job, seeking employment, there are a lot of things that we as adults don't exemplify. You know, they just see us going to work, coming home, going to work, coming home. They don't see the preparation that we put into to looking for a job, how we interview for a job, how we show up at the job, how we carry ourselves at the job. So it's very, very important for people like you to educate our youth when there's a single parent home where there is not time. Well, there always is time for your children, but time isn't being made for the child.
Yeah, you and you know, and then you have parents out there who are working two jobs.
Right,
you know?
Absolutely.
Isaac, do you give any information to, like, the young 12, 13, 14? Is this just preparing them for getting a job when they get older, or for creating your own jobs now with their talents and abilities, or how do you go about talking to them about job preparation?
You know, I think job preparation it's very versatile, and you don't have to really limit that into, like, employment. Like, you can say certain things, like, you need a strong work ethic in the classroom. You need a strong work ethic, you know, if you're on the sports team. And that's some of the things that I talk about. So, like, necessarily a 12 or 13-year-old kid might not really be interested in working right now, but they could be interested in making the soccer team or the football team. So, you know, I just always tell them, like, hey, you know, you got to continue to do hard work no matter what you're doing.
Right.
You got to continue to be dedicated no matter what age you're doing. If you want to be a ballerina dancer, you got to be dedicated. You got to be on time. Mm-hmm. And it's just things that are versatile to the, you know, workforce as well. So
that's a great approach.
It really is.
It is. My first job was military, so it was like right in your face. This is what you should do, is demanding. There was really no one to tell me, but I had parents that were also in the military, so it was kind of ingrained in us. But the kids that I grew up with, once we got out of high school and we started looking for jobs, I realized that they really didn't know how to approach, you know, going for a job. And it was just the most amazing thing to me.
Right, but Isaac, tell me how do you feel about this question? You stay in school from preschool, some, up to 12th grade.
Okay.
No one teaches you about job preparation. You get the question?
Yeah.
I think some point it should be somewhere in the curriculum or some sort of class that you have to take for resume building and job preparation and all the things that you are doing. It's like you're adding to their curriculum. However, don't you think it should be included in their academics?
Yeah, absolutely. I've been battling with our school board here where I live at to see if we can create something, you know, maybe just a workshop. Even if the school board can't do it, then I would just do it personally, get a couple of key leaders in and create a workshop. You know, but I just think, you know, my dad told me, you know, he was a very straightforward guy. Didn't really say, you know, doesn't really say much, but what he does say is very powerful.
Okay.
But, I remember before I got my first job, when I came home and told him, I was like, yeah, I got my first job. And he was just like, okay, you know, you laid the framework, now create a legacy. And so like for like 2 weeks, I struggled, like, what does that mean? Like, how do I create my legacy? Like, what do I do?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was because, like, no one really held my hand and walked through it, and I had to fall a few times that I was just like, okay, so now I see what he's talking about. You know, so to answer that question, yeah, it's going to be tough, but it's almost like you just have to go out and look for the resources, you know, see if there's anything out there. And if not, just be willing to fall down a few times, you know, be willing to fail a few times before you achieve overall success.
Right. Because nothing fails but a quitter.
Right, right.
Mm. Okay, then let's talk about some of your methods you use with working and speaking with the youth. So explain to our listening audience, like, what your, like, workshop would be like. Do you do workshops?
Yes, I'm starting workshops this year.
Okay.
That'll be, like, my first mission there. So
what would your workshops be like? I mean, what should people expect to receive from you when you show up on the scene?
It's always very interactive. Like, I try to get everyone interacting, you know, make everyone feel important. And then I want you to get comfortable. So I might throw in a little comedy, you know, anything like that.
Okay.
And then basically, at first, I want to see if we can address anything that someone may be holding on to. Maybe, what is this workshop even about, you know? Mm-hmm. So I try to address any, like, you know, elephants in the room, and then we just dive right in. So the first workshop that I'm planning, it's a physical development, and it's just, like, how to even pick a diet plan that works for you.
Okay.
And, you know, I central it around you. So what we'll do, like I said, we'll do all those steps, and then we'll go in, and we'll start researching diet plans, you know, what a football athlete should eat and, you know, drink and things like that. So we'll research that, and we'll do it together.
Okay.
And I feel like once we do it together, you know, people will have more of a, like, you'll have more of a sense, like, wow, you know, he's really with me. You know, this guy he's really able to help. And that's just my approach. Like, I just always want you to know that I'm here for you, you know, through the good times and the bad times.
So do you do any mock interviews?
Oh, yeah, all the time, all the time.
Okay.
And so, like, how I do it, we'll do the interview first, and, you know, without any, you know, any help or tips or things like that, and then we'll go back, correct anything that, you know, maybe, you know, the person's messed up on.
Right.
Then we'll go back and fix those mistakes and then do it all over again. So,
okay.
Like a corrective coaching, I guess you can say.
And so the group that I saw on your page, how many children were those you were working with?
So that was a leadership group. It was like 60 children in there.
Oh, wow. That was a lot I saw.
Yeah, it was a lot of kids. And I just talked about leadership.
Mm-hmm.
I just told them what I thought leadership meant to me. The first thing I said was that leadership means something different to everyone in this room. And so I just threw out my definition of leadership, what it means. I told them that for me, it's effort, commitment, and confidence. And so I had those kids like brainstorm what they might think leadership is to them. And
okay.
We came up with some great responses.
Okay.
I think we've got our eighth caller.
Yes, we do.
Caller, are you on the line?
Caller, are you on the line?
Yes.
Well, hi there.
Hello, how are you doing?
We're doing great. And you are the eighth caller. Can I get your name?
My name is Amitris Terry.
Amitris.
Amitris, A-M-E,
mm-hmm.
T-R-I-C-E.
T-R-I-C-E. Okay. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And is this your first time listening to the show?
Yes.
Oh, well, great. How'd you hear about it?
Actually, one of my coworkers told me about it.
Oh, okay. Well, wow. Goodness. Well, then you're going to be on your way to Lake Winnie.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Okay.
So I'm so glad we have our eighth winner.
Oh, okay.
That is so awesome. And so where do you live?
I live in Lithonia.
In Lithonia. Okay, okay. So we're going to take all of your information. I will definitely call you after the show is over,
mm-hmm.
so we can set up arrangements on you getting those tickets. And also be sure to continue to tune in because we'll be doing this every week. But don't just tune in for the giveaways. Tell people about
okay.
it and come on over and, you know, share some information and engage with our guests and what have you. And so how do you like the show so far today?
Interesting. That's good. Yeah, my coworker, she just kind of sent me a message that, listen, turn to the station and listen. I said, okay. She's always thinking to me, she said, I think they're going to have a getaway and this will be good for you and your kid.
Oh, see, well, that's okay. A blessing. I feel so good. I feel so good. And they were meant for you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So you called in at the right time, right?
Well, thank you.
You are so welcome. And again, I want to thank you for tuning in to the Kelissa in the Morning Show.
Congratulations.
Yes, congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay. Hold the line. We'll get your number, your contact information, so we can get those tickets to you.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you so much for listening.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. All right.
All right. Well, we had a winner.
Yes,
Nitris Terry
mm-hmm.
from Lithonia, Georgia.
Lithonia, Georgia.
Now, next week, that can be you.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you're just tuning in, you're listening to the Kelissa in the Morning Show, we have a 9:30 giveaway that we're proud of.
Yes, we are.
You've given away gas cards, and you've given away
tickets to amusement park.
Yeah.
And I looked online. Lake Winnie looks like an awesome, awesomely fun place to go.
It is. And mm-hmm. it's not in Atlanta. So if you're not in Atlanta, you can call in,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Yeah.
You can reach us here at 866-923-2860. Put that in your Rolodial. If you are in Atlanta, 404-355-8699.
That's right.
So we'd love to get some feedback on how the show is going.
Yes.
Love to give away some prizes.
And tell more people.
And tell some folks about the show.
Mm-hmm.
And matter of fact, we want to hear from you. What should we be talking about? What do you want to talk about?
Right.
You know, what's going on in your life that's going to impact your life and other people's life?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have solutions here, you know,
we
just
do.
Through dialogue.
And the guests that I have on the show, they are people that are actually that could really help. And I know there are a lot of single parents out there and not just women, but men as well. And we can all collectively or collaboratively work together to help one another. You know, if you got some teenagers or some little boys or. Oh, you know, you want to get it. You have a group that you want someone to come speak. I mean, I'm available. You know, you can book me. And then you have Isaac Moore Jr., who's on the line.
Right.
Right, Isaac?
You still there, Isaac? We might have lost Isaac. Isaac, Mr. Moore, are you there?
Yeah, I'm still
you're
there.
Here. Okay. There he is. Okay. So I was just telling the listening audience about booking you for to come out and help with the youth. You know, it's the summertime, and it's a lot of youth out here that could use, you know, your expertise.
Are looking for jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
A lot of kids, especially here in Atlanta, are sitting there, you know, they're sitting on their hands during the summer. You
right.
know, especially
yeah.
the
yeah.
age group between 12 and 16, 17. There are a lot of programs that allow underage youth to work, you know, here in the city. And,
okay.
But they, a lot of times they don't know about it.
They don't know about
you know,
it,
they
right.
don't know about it. So people like you are wealths of information for these parents that can put their children to work, especially those that are 16 through 18.
Yes.
And are thinking about going to college or thinking about getting right out of high school and getting a job. Man, they need the training.
Mm-hmm.
Instead
they
of
do.
Standing around getting in trouble all
exactly.
summer.
Exactly. Yeah. And an idle mind is a devil's workshop.
Absolutely. A lot of kids get in trouble here in Atlanta over the summer. Right in their junior and their senior year, they never return back to high school.
Mm.
Yeah, because they don't see a productive way of spending their summer.
Mm-hmm.
Summer is not just all about swimming pools and football games and things like that. It's not. It's
right.
about self-development.
Yes, and that's where your program comes in, I'm sure. Isaac?
Yeah, absolutely. So, like, it's funny that you mentioned about kids getting in trouble. I actually mentor a kid, and he got into some trouble his senior year of high school. And, like, I went to court, and I just stood up and was just like, you know, can I work with him? Like, let me work with him. Give me a chance.
Right.
And so, like, now this kid, he's on the right track. He's going to graduate from college with an associate's degree in criminal justice.
Oh, wow.
So, that's what's up.
That
you know,
is
it,
awesome. So you still mentor him?
A little. I mean, we talk on a day-to-day basis. I wouldn't necessarily say, well, I guess you can say I mentor him. You know, I still, you know, talk to him and encourage him and things like that.
So, mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can say I still mentor him a little bit.
I'm sure you do that for a lot of your students you work with, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Wow. So on a yearly basis, oh, well, actually, that's not a fair question. Since you've been doing this, how many students have you impacted?
If you know, if I had to take a guess, I'd probably say over about 300 students.
Wow.
Wow.
I do a lot of coaching, mm-hmm. volunteer coaching, and so I always try to build a relationship when I'm coaching. So,
okay.
It's over about 300 students, if I had to take a guess.
He said only about 300.
Only. It's probably being modest.
I see.
So tell the listening audience, Isaac, how do you measure your success?
That's a tough question.
Really? well, first you've written a book, correct?
Yes.
Okay, you self-publish it. That takes a lot to do, and then you're a coach for the youth. You go and help with job preparation and skill development and all sorts of things.
He's
you
in
know?
School.
Yeah. And you go to school, correct?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So you're doing a lot. So I personally think it's awesome. You know, I think it's phenomenal what you're doing. And
thank
I just kind of wanted to know, how did you measure your success?
I don't know. Like, I really...
You don't look at it in a measuring
light,
right?
You know, I just really see it as me doing God's work, you know. Every morning I wake up, I pray and I meditate and I always ask God for, like, strength,
uh-huh.
Guidance, and, like, confidence, you know. And, like, you know, I really don't look at things, you know, in a measurement. I just look at it and he's, you know, just doing what I have to do to, you know, lead the world better than, you know, how I found it.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Well, that says a lot.
That's what's up. Wow. You know, that's important to have some guidance, and the guidance that you are giving to the young people, I'm sure, is a life changer for them. So, are there ever any times where a child or a young person that you have been involved with on the life coaching arena that have come back to you and said, hey, man, because of you, this is where I am?
Oh, yeah. You know, I always get students, like I usually coach like fifth and sixth grade basketball. So I always get students that will come back to me when they move on to like junior high, and they'll say, you know what, hey, coach, you know, I made my seventh grade team, I made my eighth grade team. And I'm like, hey, congratulations, you know, hard work paid off. And they're just like, no, you know, if you weren't so tough on me, then, you know, I never would have made it. And you know, it, to me, it's just like, okay, now I know that I got to keep going. You know, I got to keep going.
And
know?
It's rewarding because you know that it's really making a difference in a child's life.
Wow. You don't seem like like you're a hard-hitting fella, but I'm sure you are on that court. So what are some of the things that you will implement if a child falls short willingly, always late to practice, not doing the best that they can do? What are some of the things that you implement in their regiment?
You know, I always give them like an option. You know, I feel like, you know, some people have told me like this method is like a gift and a curse, but I always give a child that option. I always say like, you don't have to be here. And, you know, and I'm okay with that.
Right.
But if you're going to be here, then, you know, you have to listen. You have to be on time. And then I give them like that option. It's like, you can stay or you can leave. I'm like, if you stay, I can help you. If not, then it's on you. And I think once you show them that you really care about them, it takes on a different way, different demeanor.
Okay.
Wow, that's awesome.
And then it helps them with decision making as well, because those are quick decisions. Look, what do I need to do? What am I going to do here? You know, and then ultimately it's the consequences they have to deal with when you give them a decision.
Absolutely.
Wow, that's awesome. That's awesome, awesome. So are you thinking about expanding your services nationally? Are you just working where you are right now, or what are your plans?
Actually, I do want to take it nationally. Like this year, 2016 was a really, really, like, great year for me so far.
Okay.
I plan to get better, so, like, I'm working on taking it nationally. We had a fundraiser. And they raised like $1,000 for me, you know, to expand and, you know, just really get off the ground. You know, I want to launch like a full, you know, speaking, you know, business where we just travel, impact as many people as possible.
Wow.
I mean, that's my goal. Still working on it, you know, so, and I'm willing to put in the work, you know, I won't shy away from hard work. You know, I'm willing to do whatever it takes, you know, since me losing, you know, night's sleep, I'm ready for it.
Well, it sounds like it. It really does. Give our listening audience a brief inspirational message.
If I can give a brief message, you know, it would be like, you know, wake up and just, you know, give it your all.
Right.
You know, because you can always fail at doing what you don't want to do. So at least, like, why not try? Go ahead and try to do what you want to do.
Correct.
Because failure is always going to be there, no matter what it is.
Right.
You know, you're always going to have failure in your mindset. I'm sorry, you're always going to have failure, you know, looming around. So.
But that doesn't mean you have to succumb to it.
Exactly. And if I am failing, I would rather fail on doing something that, you know, I wanted to do this instead of waking up and it's like, man, I didn't really want to do that anyway, you know.
I understand. You asked me, what you said was pivotal. Success is everywhere, but failure is everywhere as well. And just because we fail doesn't mean that we're a failure.
That's
it
right.
It just means that's a lesson learned. You got to keep it moving.
That's right. So, always.
Wow.
Always.
Wow. Well, much success with your book, 9 to 5. Explain 9 to 5 really quick and how we can get a hold of it.
All right, sure thing. So it's available on Amazon. If you guys go to Amazon Books, just type in 9 to 5, Isaac Moore. The book will pop up. Like I said, I got the title. I was in a store one day, and a lady was on the phone, and she must have been really upset about her job. And so she was on the phone, and she was just like, I'm tired of working overnights. I need a 9-to-5. And I was like, okay. Let me do something with this. Uh-huh. So now anytime someone's like, man, I need a 9-to-5, I just whip out a book.
Uh-huh. You just whip out a book. That's right.
I just whip out a book.
How do you go about getting your books out to the public?
Outside
of the Amazon.
Mm-hmm. Outside of Amazon, locally, what I try to do, I'm working on a website to make it. I had a website, but it wasn't as interactive and it wasn't as simplistic as I'd like it to be for anyone who wants to order a book. So now what I'm doing, I started a fundraiser. Mm-hmm. And with this book, I mean, with the fundraiser, it is going to, I'm just going to purchase books and I'm just going to go anywhere possible on like a 2-week journey and just start sending out books free of charge.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
I want one. 9-to-5. Yeah, we have some children that need your expertise, man, especially coming from a young person that just hit the ground running. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that really is. So much success in your collegiate career as well.
Thank you.
So are you on track to graduate, or are you divvying out your time evenly to where you can do it all? Of course you are.
Yeah. I wanted to graduate this past year, but I'm just like, you know, it'll be better, you know, health-wise,
mm-hmm.
and better for me, you know, to just stretch it out.
Yeah.
Like I was taking like 16 credit hours.
Ooh.
Working full-time, you know, and I'm just like, a little bit better if I just stretch it out. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's not enough of you to do all that.
do all that.
That's a lot of work. All right.
So, Isaac, go ahead and tell the listening audience how they may contact you and what are the best ways to get in touch with you to obtain more information or to donate to you and your cause and what you're doing with the youth.
Absolutely. So I'm always attached to my phone. Sorry to say, but you can always email me. The email address is Isaac, ISAAC. more, @outlook.com. That's my email. I'll always respond to emails. My phone number, I'll give you guys my phone number in case you ever just want to have a nice conversation. It's 219-561-6645. And if you guys want to help with the fundraiser, which would be greatly appreciated, there's a fundraising website called Generosity.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to that page, and then you can type in 925 book tour, and it's like 9, it's spelled out, N-I-N-E, and then 2, the number 2, and then 5, F-I-V-E. And then, like I said, go to Generosity, type in 925 book tour,
mm-hmm.
speaking tour, and like just donate. And hopefully I get you guys emails, and I'll always send you updates of what I'm doing, pictures, you know, who I inspire.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can just hop on Facebook. I'll try to keep it updated, but a lot of people always say I'm on Facebook too much. So,
no, can never be on Facebook too much. When you're trying to brand yourself and market yourself, it's never too much.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, how's your fundraiser going so far? How long have you been doing it?
Honestly, I just started about a week ago. Like, I always prided myself on just doing it, like just working hard, saving up my own personal money.
Yeah.
And then, like, I met with somebody, and it was just like, you know, hey, you know, it's okay to do a fundraiser sometimes. And I'm
mm-hmm.
just like, I don't know. Like, I want to do it myself. So, you know, I was coaxing and doing a fundraiser, and I'm just like, well, let me give it a try, you know, see how it goes. And
no, don't give it a try. Give it a go.
Yeah.
Hey, businesses and all over the country do it, you know.
Yeah,
and then there are businesses who like to support entrepreneurs, speakers, and people who are
trying to give it a go.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said.
Trying to give it a go.
Absolutely.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I really commend you for what you're doing. I really appreciate you for tuning into the show. We are coming onto the show as my featured guest. And we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. And we appreciate, again, just one more time, give us your contact information again in case someone missed or someone's just joining so that they can get in contact with you to help.
All right. The email address is Isaac E. Moore, AACE, then MOORE, at Outlook.com. Then my phone number is 219-561-6645. And then, like I said, I got the online fundraiser going. If you go to generosity.com, you'll get a little search bar at the top. Go ahead and type in 925. That's N-I-N-E, 2, the number 2, and then 5, F-I-V-E. And then type in 9-to-5 book tour, and it'll pop up. Hopefully you guys donate. I'm always grateful for donations. And, like, I really want to travel the world and start passing out books.
Okay. Well, sounds great. I commend you for what you're doing. And I'd like to thank you again and express my appreciation for your grace to appear with me today on
thank
the Kelissa in the Morning Show.
Thank you. Hey, you all have a great day.
You do the same.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
We'd like to give a special thanks to our sponsors, I Am Life T-shirts by TNT Creations, where the feeling of life begins, and to our 9:30 giveaway sponsor, Greater Works Mission, headed by Candace Ruffin.
Yes.
Thank you, Miss Candace. We love you. We hope you're listening.
Yes. And briefly, let's go ahead and give a little brief description about Greater Works.
Okay. Oh, let's
see. Now, Greater Works is headed by evangelist Candace Ruffin.
Candace was actually a guest on our show.
Mm-hmm.
What was that? Was it the fifth show?
The fourth or the fifth show. And I think it really went awesome. And, you know, all the work that she's doing, she's also going to be a speaker this weekend in the Atlanta area at the
HRNS
giveaway and summit. And so I'll be speaking there as well. And so you guys can come out to that. But Candace is the evangelist of Greater Works Mission, and it's a nonprofit organization that helps college students with personal care packages. So they go to college campuses, and they give out what they call champion bags for future leaders. She began the organization in 2013, and they do fundraising to purchase the items to give away free. Again, to college students,
right,
which I think is good because college students really struggle, making ends meet.
Absolutely.
You
eating
know.
Ramen and hot dogs, I remember.
Ramen and hot dogs. So, you know, I think it's awesome what she's doing. If you want to get in touch with Ms. Ruffin, please, her email is gwmissions1051@yahoo.com. And the website is gwmissions1051.com, or you can feel free to give her a call at area code 832-696-3964.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Great.
And we
works.
Really appreciate her for becoming a sponsor of the show. It's really helpful and appreciated.
So time is wrapping up.
It is.
Thank you for joining us on the show today. We want you to know that we're grateful for your support. You've been listening to the Kelissa in the Morning Show. We hope you've enjoyed the time we spent together this morning. We're confident that you are educated and absolutely inspired. So please tune in next week.
That's right.
Yeah.
Same time.
Thursday, 9 to 10.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right here on WAEC, Love 860, Atlanta's inspirational talk radio. And until next week, we say
goodbye.
Have a great one.
Have a great one. Make it a great day, everybody.
Thank you for listening to Kelissa in the Morning. Be sure to tune in every Thursday, 9 to 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on WAEC, Love 860.